BBC Audio presents This Repulsive Woman by Christopher Reason.
Is it Deborah?
Sorry?
Deborah Hurst?
I guess.
Why do you have to guess?
No one calls me Deborah. Can't remember the last time. Always either Debbie or Debs. Did they let you smoke in here?
I don't think
so. Well, what are they going to do to me? Like I'm not in enough trouble.
It says Deborah on your file.
Yeah, but don't pretend you don't read the papers. Be about the only beggar who don't.
The papers don't interest me.
Well, you should, if you want to laugh. I got all the clippings here, look. See? Got them with me.
Yeah, I'm not here to discuss what the papers have said about you. So, Deborah or Debbie?
Deborah.
OK. Deborah. Why are you smiling?
I don't know. Deborah. They must have called me that in court, but I can't have been listening. Sounds funny. Deborah. Go on.
But, you'll have got my letter introducing myself.
I've had a lot of letters. None of them very nice.
About today, I mean. I'm a probation officer. My name's Tony. Tony Jukes.
Right. So is that Tony or Anthony?
Tony, usually.
And is that what you want to be called?
I don't know. If you're going to be Deborah, maybe I should be Anthony. What do you reckon?
Fine. Anthony.
Are we going to sit down? Now, you know why I'm here today.
You're the bloke who decides how long I'm going to get, yeah?
No, that is strictly in the hands of the judge. I'm here to draw up what's called a pre-sentence report.
But the judge is going to read that, yeah?
Yes.
And what you say is going to be what makes him decide, yeah?
Well, it helps him decide.
Well, if he listens to what the papers are saying, they're going to throw away the key.
The newspapers don't decide sentences in this country yet.
My brief says if the press hadn't got hold of it, I might have got off with probation. As it is, I might be looking at 10 years.
I can't enter into this kind of speculation, I'm afraid, Deborah.
10 years is what killers get. How old will I be when I get out? 44? How old will our page be?
I can't enter into speculation.
21. I've kids of my own by then.
Yeah, as I say.
I'll be a grandma. And I've missed it. Our cousin Joey got done for GBH, took a fella's eye out, got 8 years, and he were out in 5. One mention on Galaxy News when he went down. Compare that with me. Who've I hurt? Whose eye have I taken out? What are you supposed to use for an ashtray round here?
Had a vanilla custard on my way in. I've still got the tin thingy.
So there is a God. What?
Nothing.
You thought I was going to use the floor, didn't you?
No.
Did you not read what they said about the state of my house? The names they called me?
Yeah, as I say...
Slut, slag, ugly, fat.
We're not here to discuss any of that.
Well, Paige have read it, do you think?
I very much doubt it.
Have you spoke to her at all?
No, that's not my area of responsibility.
Why isn't she coming to see me?
I don't know.
Them foster parents are poisoning her mind. That's why she's not been. Is there someone you could speak to?
Not really, no.
I've written her letters. 3 letters. Only she don't write back. They want to make out like I don't love my kids. But I do. I love all my kids, even the ones I've not seen since they were babies. You never forget them.
You've had how many children?
Oh, don't pretend like you don't know. Can't say anything about me. TV, papers, radio, without mentioning 6 kids by 5 different fathers. Like the whole world don't know.
Debbie, can we forget the papers? I want it from you.
Hear what you just called me then? That didn't last long, did it?
Sorry, Deborah.
Yes, Anthony.
And how many of those children were living with you at the time of the offence?
2. Jordan and Paige.
And the others?
Ashley and Candice are adopted.
Uh-huh.
Try and Chase are in care, though I still get to see them in the holidays. Well, I did before all this happened.
So, of the two that were still with you, Jordan is how old?
18 months. And Paige was 11 the week before last. Hmm. Sent her a card and a present. High School Musical, free on DVD. She loves all the High School Musical stuff.
I'm right in thinking Paige and Jordan were also in the care of the local authority, but that they were allowed to live with you?
What do you reckon the chances I'll ever see them again, eh?
I've really no idea, I'm afraid. Right.
Ooh, he's carrying his pen out. We're getting down to business now.
A few things I need to go over. You stood trial for taking indecent photographs of a child under the Protection of Children Act 1978, yes?
I never took no photos. I haven't even got a camera. She was stood in front of a webcam.
You pleaded not guilty, but were tried and convicted. In the light of that conviction, how do you feel about the not guilty plea now?
It were now.
Well, you say that.
It were now. I've said it a million times, but nobody listens. What harm did she come to? Eh? Not let anyone touch her or fiddle with her, let alone, well, you know, anything like that. Kids go through 100 times worse every day. She didn't even know it was happening. No idea. She was practising for High School Musical. That's what she was doing.
Naked except for a pair of pants.
She wore a bikini. See what I told the jury? Only they were so full of the stuff they read in the papers, they weren't listening. The whole thing was her idea.
I'm sorry?
It what?
Removing the bikini top, that was Paige's idea,
I don't know how that happened.
It says here, naked except for a pair of cutaway pants.
The proper word is thong.
Thank you for putting me right on that one.
OK, you want to know? This is what I told the jury. This is what happened. Paige loves singing and dancing. She watches all the programmes. X Factor, Britain's Got Talent, Strictly Come Dancing, that other one with the bloke. All of them. High School Musical, of course. Couldn't shut her up. Always singing, using an airbrush as a microphone, walking down the stairs like she's Britney Spears or someone. And I swear on my mother's grave, none of that were my idea. It all come from her. She loved it.
And was it her idea to undress in front of the webcam?
Are you deaf? What did I just tell you? She didn't undress. She wore a bikini. That she chose. And all right, the top come off, but what's the big deal? It's not like she's got anything up top.
Deborah, you exhibited your daughter virtually naked in front of a webcam to paedophiles for money. Fact.
So? Were it my idea to get the computer in the first place, eh? Well, were it?
How is that relevant?
Where's that article?
Debbie, this isn't really the time.
Deborah.
I haven't come here to read your press clippings.
Here we go. This is the one. Read that. Go on.
I'd rather not.
Read it, Anthony. Only take a minute. Out loud. Come on. I want to hear too.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.